Every now and then, as a member of this esteemed House, we get an opportunity to stand on the floor and speak on a piece of legislation that is dear and close to our hearts. Today is one of those days, and this is one of those bills that is near and dear to me. As I stand here today, I am joined by my children, Thomas and Deirdre, who have known nothing but Pennsylvania state politics their entire lives. Their father, the late Honorable Robert C. Donatucci, who they knew simply as Dad, was a member of this House from the time he was first elected in a special election on March 11, 1980, until the day he passed on November 9, 2010. For 30 years, he served the people of the 185th District, and a week before his passing, they elected him to his 16th term. Many of you knew him. You have stories of partnerships and battles. And all of you knew of his dedication and commitment to the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and his respect for this legislature. His constituents have many stories. Some still share a tale or two when they visit the district office or see me on the street. Bob helped everyone, both professionally and personally. After losing Bob, my children approached me about doing something to honor their father and to commemorate his service to the body of his constituents. To this body and his constituents. What better way to honor his service and dedication to his district and family than to name in his memory one of the three bridges that connect the 185th District? House Bill 1599 will designate the bridge on a portion of State Route 3019 over the Schuylkill River in the city of Philadelphia as the Honorable Robert C. Donatucci Memorial Bridge. Bob would be embarrassed by this honor. But it is proper and fitting that we do this for a man who dedicated his life to serving and helping the citizens of the 185th District in a variety of ways. Robert lived to serve, and I only wish he could be here to see for himself the impact he made on so many. As a wife and as a fellow member of this House, I thank you for the unanimous passage of this bill and for honoring the man that gave so much to his district and the House of Representatives. Thank you. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you, Representative Donatucci. Located to the left of the rostrum, the chair welcomes Representative Donatucci's son, Thomas, and her daughter, Deirdre Donatucci. Please rise. The chair recognizes Representative McGeehan.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. And I thank Representative Donatucci for the privilege of addressing the chamber because for more than 20 years, Bob was a dear and trusted friend of mine and to many in this chamber. There are a couple old-timers still left in this body who remember Bob's quiet, steady, reliable presence in the back row. I say quiet because Bob is part of the old school. And when I say old school, I mean that in the best sense. While he was a loyal and true Democrat, as chairman of the House Liquor Control Committee, I think it'll be part of the historical record that Bob was never let partisanship get in the way of progress for this Commonwealth, and I know that every chairman that served with him can attest to that fact. Bob was not a show horse, he was a workhorse. And when I say quiet, Bob was quiet. As a matter of fact, when Maria was sworn in, she gave a speech on the first day and she sat down and I said, "Congratulations, Maria." She said, "What for?" I said, "You beat Bob's record of words spoken on the House floor on your very first day." But that quietness of Bob's belied a true passion for this work, for a commitment to the citizens he was entrusted to represent. It belied a keen intellect and a decency that is unrivaled in the long history of that district. I can remember Deirdre and Tommy as infants on the House floor and many of the swearings in, and now they're beautiful young adults. He is still missed in this body. He is missed by his friends and his colleagues, but most particularly by his family, who this wonderful tribute ensures that Bob's record of achievement and service will never be forgotten. Thank you, Madam Speaker.